Now, so far, we have only worked with the decision variant of vertex cover. So what about the optimization problem? Actually, that's not that difficult. We just run through all values of k. So we will first start out assuming k equals 1. Then our algorithm requires O of 2.4 to the power of 1 times n cubed time. Then we'll increase k to 2. Algorithm requires 2.4 to the power of 2 times n cubed time. So each time we're solving the decision problem here. Then we increase k even further to k equals 3 and so on and so on and so on. Until we hit some value, k prime, which is the size of the smallest vertex cover of the input graph. Of course, we don't know what that size will be in advance, but once we have increased k enough, solving the decision variant will give us the answer yes. Now, how much running time is this in total? Well, you need to know a bit of discrete mathematics for this, but the running time overall is 2.4 to the power of 1 plus 2.4 to the power of 2 and so on until you hit 2.4 to the power of k prime times n cubed. Now, if you've had a discrete math course and remember what you learned there, you will recognize this part here as a geometric series, and this evaluates to 2.4 to the power of k prime minus 1 minus 1 over 2.4 minus 1, which is the same as O of 2.4 to the power of k prime, and k prime is the size of the smallest vertex cover, times n cubed. And we forgot the n cubed here. We'll just put it here. And this is amazing, because now it means that not only the decision variant of vertex cover can be solved in 2.4 to the power of k times n to the power of 3 time, but it means that the optimization variant of vertex cover can also be solved in O of 2.4 to the power of k times n cubed time, where k is the minimum size of a vertex cover for the input graph. And this, again, emphasizes the fact small vertex covers are easy to find. Even if we don't know that a graph has a small vertex cover, as long as it is small, it will be easy to find. And for any fixed k, so either in the decision variant we fix k, or we say we look at all graphs that, say, have a vertex cover of size 10 or 20 or 30, we can solve this NP-complete problem in polynomial time. And this is a concept known as fixed parameter tractability. What that means is that as long as the parameter that measures the hardness, and in this case it's the size of a vertex cover for your graph, as long as that parameter is small or fixed, then you can solve that problem in polynomial time. And that is what this here says. So as long as the parameter is fixed, the problem is tractable. If the parameter is not fixed, so for example it is some function of n, then the problem is not tractable. And this of course is a super neat technique for solving vertex cover. And actually 2.4 to the power of k is actually a very bad exponent here. We only did that because it was easier to explain the problem that way. The currently best algorithms have a exponential factor of about 1.3 to the power of k. Actually, a current state of the art is that you can solve vertex cover in 1.3 to the power of k times some polynomial time. Now, the polynomial here, that depends on certain analysis factors and so on. But the important thing here is to see, first of all, vertex cover is fixed parameter tractable. And second of all, the base of the exponent is actually really good. It's only 1.3 to the power of k.